Blackstone Publishing presents A Demon in Silver, Book 1 of War of the Archons by R.S. Ford. This book is read by Derek Perkins. This book is dedicated to John Jarrold. May he never retire. Onwards. Prologue. Sif wept as torn banners fluttered in the breeze. The tattered remnants of a dozen armies lay scattered and broken on the once lush plain, and broken armour shone lambent in the sun, where it wasn't spattered red. Darius had seduced the guardians of the Blue Tower, twisting them to his will. He had made them promises, given them a new eidolon to worship, and for their loyalty they had been swept aside like dust. Sif knelt amidst the carnage, Bezial's body cradled across her lap. He had been her most loyal disciple, captain of her guard, high priest, lover. Now he was dead. Her finger traced a furrow that marred his bright armour. Where her tears fell upon his breastplate, it displaced the red as though the blood feared her grief. Bezial had led the vanguard, bellowing her name, riding forth on a black steed with its hooves aflame, sword aloft. Now he lay still, his voice forever silenced. Sif felt the loss deeply, and her tears fell until her black hair was abruptly swept about her face by a gust of turbulent air. She looked up to see a creature of unparalleled beauty, a beauty only matched by its cruelty. Inelan swooped down on Nightingale's wings, landing amidst the shattered landscape with a feather-like touch. Her pure white hair billowed in the breeze, her robe black as a starless night, hands slick with crimson. She paused, surveying the scene of carnage before stepping forward, bare feet treading lithely through the scattered weapons and fallen pennants. The hem of her robe trailed through the gore and the viscera, and soon her feet were stained as crimson as her hands. She smiled, reveling in the butchery. "Was all this worth it?" Inelan said, surveying the scene before settling her eyes on Bezial. "All this death?" Sif recognized the insincerity in that question. Inelan's lust for slaughter was legend. "It has to be," replied Sif. Despite her sorrow, she knew the death of Bezial was a small price to pay for the catastrophe she would avert if they had been in time. "And now we have to scale the tower. Who knows what damage has been done?" Inelan silently nodded in agreement, making for the tower in the distance. It soared up into the darkening sky, blue walls sheer and roiling like the sea. Sif looked longingly at her first knight, before gently laying him down on the grass to his final rest. She followed Inelan across the devastated field, eerie in its silence. The battle had been costly, but it was a price that had to be paid. The Blue Tower had held the Hearthstone in its lofty prison for millennia. When it had come under threat, there was no alternative but to fight. Sif spied Armadon sitting amidst the carnage, wiping his giant blade with one of the worthless banners. He was covered in gore from the top of his horned head to the bottom of his cloven hooves, but he kept his weapon clean. His brutality turned Sif's stomach, but allying with him had been a necessity. She needed all the Archons she could muster, and Armadon was the most ferocious of their number. If it was to be war, she needed him at her side. "The tower awaits us, brother," Inelan said. He looked up, regarding the white-haired Archon with disdain. "I am no brother of yours. Once this is done with, our alliance will be over, and we can return to the fight like we always have." Inelan smiled as though relishing the thought. Armadon rose wearily. Naturally, of all the slaughter today, the lion's share belonged to him. He tilted his huge head to one side, cracking the joints and sinew of his thick neck. "Let's see an end to this," he said. The three of them walked slowly towards the tower, blue marble stretching to the sky. Dread built within Sif as they walked in through the huge carved archway. Seraphs were hewn into the stone, silently trumpeting their entrance. Marble stairs spiraled upwards into blinding light, and Sif took every step with reverence. Behind her, Inelan trod the white stairway, leaving bloody imprints in her wake.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.